Welcome to our Microsoft Dynamics 365 Marketing Overview. In this video, I will be showing you what a potential marketing solution could look like. Today, I will be focusing on the outbound marketing section of the app, as well as the event capabilities within the system, covering key features such as segments, customer journeys, email marketing, event management, and more. At this point, I would like to mention that the demo shown today is just an example of what a potential solution could look like, as a marketing app is a bespoke solution that can be customized to fit a business's unique needs and requirements. To open the outbound marketing section of the app, we would use this section here on the navigational menu and select the outbound marketing section. Here we can see various features, and one of these features we can see are subscription lists. These are lists of contacts that have subscribed to a particular communication sent by your organization. So for example, I have two different newsletters that a contact can opt in or out of. It is easy to manage these subscriptions through a subscription center marketing form, and this has to be included on all marketing emails sent from Dynamics. This is due to the GDPR regulations, and a contact can then easily update their marketing preferences through this, and all email preferences are then updated on the contact automatically within the system. This ensures that all communications are sent to only the contacts who have consented to receive them. Lists can also be used in customer journeys, which I will show later in the video, and they can be used to define who a particular customer journey will act on. The next section within the app that I'd like to discuss would be segments. This can be found here in the customer section of the navigational menu. These are groups of contacts that have been grouped together according to a certain criteria. If we would like to create a new segment, we can simply click this new button at the top of the command bar. This will then open up the option to create either a new static segment or a new dynamic segment. As the name suggests, a static segment cannot be changed once it has gone live. However, a dynamic segment will continue to update as contacts fall in and out of the certain qualifying criteria. For example, if my query was for any contact that is above 35, then as a contact becomes at the appropriate age, the dynamic segment would automatically adjust to include or disclude a certain contact.
On to the next section, email marketing. Creating and sending emails is often a big part of an organization's marketing activities.
In this section, I will explore the various features that are available within Dynamics 365 Marketing that support users with email communications. It's relatively straightforward to create a new email within this section as we go to this Add New Email button at the top here. And when we click on it, we are given with options of standard email templates within the system that we can use, which mainly control the formatting of such emails. Alternatively, we could also save emails that we have created as a template. As we can see, I've done here with a pragmatic monthly newsletter email, which I have created previously in the system, and then saved as a template, which I can now select. Within these marketing emails, it's easy to add personalized branding and images. So for example, here I have added the pragmatic logo and also used the company's colors. As well as that, I've also added in some sample text, and all of these areas can be saved as content blocks for future use. This feature therefore also provides employees with a tool to create emails at a much faster rate while still ensuring that the communications are all standardized to meet the company's requirements. Once you're happy with the content and the formatting of your email and it's ready to be sent, we then want to press this Go Live button with the email, and this will make it ready to be used in customer journeys and also be sent through the Test Send functionality on an email. The journey section of the app can be found here, and to give a better understanding of how these work, I've used the previously created email as a template in this Send Pragmatic Monthly Newsletter customer journey. So if we click into it, we can see that every customer journey has a start action, and this is where we define the target audience. And once the target audience is defined, in this case, it's the people who will be subscribed to the Pragmatic newsletter, Once that is defined, we then define the actions that we want the customer journey to proceed upon. And in this case, I simply wanted to send out this email. So as this is a monthly newsletter, I've also set it to be a recurring newsletter, a recurring customer journey. And so I want it to recur 12 times with an interval of 30 days. And once I have configured this to run, I will then need to click the Go Live button and this customer journey will be ready to send. The next section that I'd like to discuss would be marketing forms, which can be found underneath the internet marketing section of the Outbound marketing app. It's important to be able to capture information about the customer at various points in the marketing cycle, and this is where the marketing forms become very important, as they can be embedded onto a website or they can be sent directly to a contact through an email. To give a better overview of what some of these marketing forms may look like, I've created an example pragmatic landing page form here. Now, as this is a landing page form, this is used as a general catch-all form to just capture the general information about a specific contact. In addition to a company-specific branding, such as the logo, colors, and font, we can also customize which fields that we want to appear on the form. So here I have simple fields such as the first name, last name, and email. And once this is embedded on a website or sent out through an email and a contact has submitted the form, it will then store the information within the CRM and use it to either update an existing lead or contact or create a new one depending on if it finds a match for the first name and last name. In addition to being used as a general purpose form for gathering the contact information, marketing forms can also be used to manage subscription lists. This is done through a subscription center form, and I have an example of one I've created earlier as an example for Pragmatic, this Pragmatic subscription center form. With these forms, we can select the subscription lists in our organization. So in this example, we can see I have this Pragmatic newsletter and Dynamics newsletter, which are both existing subscription lists within the system. This provides an easy way for contacts to update their consent data by either opting in or out of these lists, as well as using this Do Not Email button to opt out of all communications through this organization. When a form is submitted of this type, the data is then matched to the contact record using this email field, and the system is automatically updated to reflect the changes made through this form. This then ensures that the organization is complying to the GDPR regulations so that when a record is updated to Do Not Email, they no longer receive any further communications from the organization. The next feature I'd like to discuss within Dynamics 365 Marketing will be the event capabilities within the system. To navigate to the events section of the app, we simply open this section underneath Event Management. Now, this is where we can both create and manage in-person and online events, which makes it easier to track things like registrations, attendees, and vendors all in one record. When creating a new event, we have a couple of different options. We could either do this from a template using this button here, or we could create a new event completely from scratch, allowing us to fill in the information manually. However, I have already set up an example event for us to go through. So I have set up this event as a conference. However, as we can see, we can also have the option to stream this event online. Once we have created the event and filled in the general required information, we can also see that there are several tabs at the top here, which each in turn prompt us to add in more information about this event. So for example, in the agenda tab, we can see a calendar of the agenda for the event, and we can add to this by creating sessions here, which would add to this calendar and make them visible to us easily. Then we have the website and form, which is specifically for online type events and use more there. Then we can also manage registration and attendance. This is easily done by creating passes which contacts can purchase and creating event registrations for specific contacts. And when the event has occurred, we can also check in the registrations easily through this standard functionality. In addition, we also have things like just standard additional information, like the outcome and the goals and the revenue, more financial information. Then we also have things like the room reservations for this specific event. So as you can see here, they're pulled through directly from the agenda, and this calendar is a view only. So we cannot add direct room reservations here. We'd have to create a new session with that specific room to create the room reservation. In addition to being able to fill in this information whenever it is required, we can also be prompted through the process by this business process flow at the top of the events form here. So for example, if this event is in a preliminary stage, then we're prompted to fill in certain information such as the event, the goal, and things like the date and time. Then if we'd move this event on to the next stage, which would be the agenda, we're then prompted to define sessions, identify sponsors, and request sponsorships, which would prompt us to fill in this agenda tab here. And the same for all of these other tabs as well. They would prompt us to fill in relevant information on the event. Once we're happy we filled in all of the required information for this particular event, we can then proceed to go live and allow contacts to register for this specific event and event and any sessions that have also gone live. After that, we can then move the business process flow along to this event post-event stage, which will then prompt us to do things such as send the thank you emails and make any necessary payments. The final feature that I will be exploring in this demo will be the various analytics that can be drawn from the data within the outbound marketing section of the app. These insights are visible at multiple stages and areas within the app and provide an in-depth analysis of your marketing activities, as well as how these are performing. These are especially useful for understanding where a business needs to improve and what areas are already performing well. The first area for insights that I will be covering will be the dashboards, which can be found here in the app. These are standard marketing dashboards, and they cover a wide variety of areas, such as customer journeys, email marketing, and general overviews of the entire marketing app. So first, starting with this overview dashboard, here we can see a high-level overview of everything in the app. So this includes things like open opportunities, leads, and any active cases, as well as some activities. And now this is a very high level overview of everything in the system. However, it's worth noting that anything in these dashboards can be completely customizable. So you can add and take away graphs as necessary. So now moving on to the email marketing dashboard. Here we can see another overview of all of the emails within the system. So we can see things like a list of all of the active marketing emails, things like the active emails by owner, and also things like their status, and then other high level information. And in addition to this, if we'd like to have more information about a specific email, we can simply click into one of these, and then this will open up the email. And then within this email record, all we have to do is we can navigate to the Insights tab, and this will give insights about this specific marketing email. So here we have things like the delivery and interactions, open times, etc. So it provides with a lot of extra analytics that are visible purely for this email. If we go back to our dashboards and we can have a look at the customer journey dashboard. Now, this is very similar to the email marketing dashboard and provides very similar information. So a list of all of the active customer journeys, the number of customer journeys by owner, etc. But we also have a breakdown of all of the customer journeys by purpose. And this is specifically useful for seeing what types of customer journeys are being the most utilized within the system and which ones we could implement more of. So similar to the marketing emails, if we'd like more insights into a particular customer journey, we can simply click on this record and then navigate to the Insights tab. And this will give us insights specific to this customer journey, such as the email delivery results and the responses over time. Now, the final area that I would like to discuss about where it's possible to see further insights would be directly on a contact record itself. So from the contact, if we navigate to the Insights tab on the form, we can see any web interactions or email interactions that that specific contact has had with the organization. And this again provides a high level overview to see how engaged that customer is in the system and in the organization.
That concludes the demo of the Dynamics 365 marketing application. The features shown here were just a small example of the capabilities within the system. For more information around these and what your bespoke solution could look like, please contact us at 0190 8038 110 or email us at sales@pragmatic.co.uk or fill out the contact form below.